two-phase method. Two-phase method is used for solving linear programming problems. So this is a linear programming problem, and two-phase method is specifically used for solving problems which has a mixture of constraints such as greater than or equal to or less than or equal to. To solve a problem in two-phase, we have to convert the problem into a maximization problem. That is, the objective function should be of maximization. Since the given question is of minimization, we are going to convert it to a maximization problem. That is done by just converting the symbols. Like if suppose it is minus, we should convert it to plus. So this will be z is equals to 2x1 plus x2. The constraints will be same. So that will be x1 plus x2 is greater than or equal to 2. x1 plus x2 is less than or equal to 4. So starting with the phase 1. In the phase 1, we will just add, suppose if it is greater than or equal to constraint, we have to add this surplus variable. For surplus variable, we will also add the artificial variable. So surplus variable is indicated by minus S1 and the artificial variable plus A1, which is equal to A2. For I am taking off the constraint, I am introducing the surplus variable and the artificial variable. And the second constraint, since it is less than or equal to constraint, I am adding the slack variable. So slack variable is represented by plus S2, which is equals to 4. Since it uses artificial variable, this two-phase method is also known as artificial variable or the penalty method. So now going to the objective function. For phase 1, I will just use the coefficient of all the variables as 0. For phase 1, I am initializing it with 0. I have variables x1 and x2, so its coefficient will be 0. And s1, s2 and a1, all those will be 0. As usual, I will subtract my artificial variable in the objective function. Now going on to the tabular column. I am specifying the variables x1, x2, S1, S2, A1, solution, ratio. In the first constraint, the higher priority is given to the artificial variable, only then to the slack or surplus variable. Since in the first constraint I have my artificial variable, I am taking it in the basic variable. And in the second constraint, I only have my slack variable, so I am just specifying it there. And then I will write the coefficients of the objective function on the top. For x1 it is 0. For x2 it is 0, for s1 it is 0, s2 0 and a1 it is minus 1. For a1 it is again minus 1 and for s2 it is 0. From the constraints I will fill this table with the coefficients from this constraint. So for x1 it is 1, for x2 also it is 1, for s1 it is minus 1, for a1 it is 1. Sorry, since s2 is not here, I am just specifying it as 0 and for a1 it is 1. And the solution is nothing but the right hand side, which is 2. For the second row, again continue with the constraint, coefficient of the constraints, 1, 1. Since there is no S1, I am putting a 0. For S2, it will again be 1. And for A1, it is 0. And the solution will be 4. So after filling the table, I have to calculate my Zj. Zj is nothing but Cbj into x. Into this variable. So minus 1 into 1 plus 0 into 1, which will be minus 1. For x2 again, minus 1 into 1 plus 0 into 1. Again it will be minus 1. Similarly for all the other things, 1, 0, minus 1. This will be minus 2 plus 0 into 4. 0 into anything is 0, so it will be minus 2. Now proceeding with Cj minus Zj. Cj is nothing but here is 0. So 0 minus of minus 1 will be 1. Similarly for everything else, 0 minus of minus 1 will be 1, minus 1, 0 and 0. And now since the given question is minimum and I have converted into a maximization problem, the maximum value should be taken. The maximum value here is 1. Since I have two 1s, any 1 can be taken. I am taking the first column. So this is nothing but my pivot column. And now for selecting the pivot row, I have to go with the ratio. So calculating of the ratio is nothing but the solution by the pivot column. So the first one will be 2 by 1 is 2, 4 by 1 is 4. The pivot row is always selected by the least positive value. The least positive value here is 2. So this will be my pivot row. I will continue with this tabular column until I get all the Cj minus Zj values should be all zeros and ones alone. So since I've already obtained zeros and minus only ones, since I have ones also, it should be less than or equal to zero alone. Since I have two positive values, one and one, I should again proceed with the second tabular column. Now filling the basic variable, since I have selected this row and this column, the artificial variable A1 will be replaced with X1. So the basic variable first one will be X1 and the second one will have no changes because it is not selected, so it is S2. So X1 coefficient is already 0, so there will be no issues, and S2 is also 0. And for calculating these values, it will be done in such a way. So the selected column will be divided by this intersected value. The intersected value here is 1. So I'll divide the whole row with 1. So it will be the same value. 1, 1, minus 1, 0, 1 and 2. And going off to the second row will be calculated in such a way that this one, this column 1, minus of again the pivot column. The pivot column for this row is again 1 into 1. So 1 minus 1 into 1 is nothing but 0. So I'll just tell another time. For the second row, the value is 1. I'll subtract it with the pivot column, which is also 1. So 1 minus 1 into this value, x2 value. So again it is 1 minus 1 into 1, which is 0. So here again I'll write it as 0 and fill it respectively for all the other rows, row values, 1, 1, minus 1 and 2. Once I have completed with this, I'll go and calculate my Zj. Since it is 0, obviously everything will result in 0. Because multiplying anything will result in 0. 0 into 1 plus 0 into 0 is again 0. So same for all the other columns. Next I'll proceed with Cj minus Zj. Since Cj is 0 and Zj is also 0, 0 minus 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 and minus 1. I'll stop the phase 1 only when I have values less than or equal to zeros. Here I have zeros and minus 1. I don't have any positive values. So I stop the phase 1 here. Now I'll proceed with the phase 2. For phase 2, there should be some modification done in the tabular column. What should be done is, artificial variable should be taken from the previous table. So my table will contain details such as CPJ, basic variable, X1, X2, S1, S2, solution and ratio. I have removed my artificial variable and this will be X1 and S2. Here it will be CJ. Here usually I was filling the values with the coefficients. And the coefficients which I have written was 0. I have considered all the coefficients as 0 for phase 1. For phase 2, I will take the values from the questions. For x1 it will be 2 and for x2 also, for x2 it is 1. So it will be x1, the given question is, in the given question it is 2. So I will write here as 2. For x2 it is 1. And for s1 and s2 it is again 0. Now I will write the rest of the values from the previous table. 1, 1, minus 1, 0, A1 is removed, so solution again is 2, X1 coefficient is 0, S2 is also 0. Similarly filling the second row, 0, 0, 1, 1, A1 is removed, so again solution will be 2. Now I will calculate my Zj. Since again the coefficients of your CPJ are 0, I will have no other value other than 0, so I can I am sorry, since the coefficient of x1 is 2 here, I will replace this with 2. So now I will obtain some value for zj. 2 into 1 is 2. 2 into 1 is again 2. 2 into minus 1 plus 0 into 1. So it is minus 2. 2 into 0 plus 0 into 1 is 0. 2 into 2 is 4 plus 0 into 2 is 0. So these are my zj values. Now cj minus zj is 2 minus 2 is 0. 1 minus 2 is minus 1. 0 minus 2, 0 minus of minus 2 is plus 2 and 0. So here the positive, the highest value, since I am solving it in a maximization problem, the positive value is 2 here. So I am selecting that column as my pivot column. And my ratio will be 2 by minus 1 will be negative value. 2 by 1 is 2. The least positive value is 2. So this will be my pivot row. Now I'll proceed with the next tableau column. Again, it will be basic variable x1, x2, s1, s2, solution, ratio, cbj, cj. Here x1 is not selected, so there will be no issues. S2 column has been selected, so I'll replace this s2 with s1. And the coefficients of x1, x2 are 2 and 1, 0, 0. For coefficient of x1 is 2. For S1 it is 0. And now again I'll solve it. Since this is my selected pivot row, I'll divide everything with the intersected value. The intersected value here is 1. So I'll divide all the values in this row with 1. 0 by anything is again 0. 0. 1 by 1 will be 1. 1 by 1 will be 1. 2 by 1 will be 2. So now going to the first row. First row values will be calculated. 1. Minus of minus 1 will be plus 1 into 0. So it is again 1. For this one it is 1 minus of, this is the pivot column, so this will be minus 1 into 0, it will be again 1. So for S1 it is minus 1 minus of, again the pivot column is minus 1, so minus 1 into 1. So it will be minus 1 plus 1, which will be 0. So S2 is, it will result in a value of 1. And my solution will be 2 minus of minus 1 into 2. So 2 plus 2, which will be 4. So now I'll calculate my ZJ values. 2 into 1 plus 0 into 0 will be 2. 2 into 1 plus 0 into 0 will again be 2. 2 into 0 plus 0 into 1 will be 0. 2 into 1 plus 0 into 1 will be 2. 2 into 4 plus 2 into 0 will be 8. Now cj minus zj. 2 minus 2, 0. 1 minus 2, minus 1. 0 minus 0, 0. 0 minus 2, minus 2. So since my question is of maximization, I will stop when all my values are less than or equal to 0. Now I have all my values less than or equal to 0. So I'll stop my tableau column with this. So the solution can be obtained such as z solution will be 8. For x1 it is 4. For x2 there is no value, so my x2 value is equals to 0. This is for maximization. But in the given question it was for minimization. So only I will add the sign, because for converting minimization into maximization, I just converted the signs from plus to minus in the objective function. So my objective function will be z here. So that is positive actually. I'm converting it to negative. And my x1 and x2 values will be the same. So this will be my final solution. Thank you.